Ain said that they were telling campaign officials to isolate if they were in contact with the president or the first lady. But we don't really know a lot. And, you know, we spoke with officials who said that earlier today there was a lot of confusion in the White House. There was some panic about what was going on, who may have been exposed. There weren't a lot of answers to questions internally, according to folks that we spoke with. And so there, it's not clear exactly how the White House is conducting its contact tracing and who they're contacting and in what form.
And Dr. Gupta, we just saw that visual of the president's family and their guests at that debate, not a lot of masks being worn. How risky are these events? This was an indoor event, obviously, it was the debate, you know, as compared to the other events that Donald Trump has done outdoors. I just wonder, you know, what is the risk factor here for what was done? And how concerning is it that it's not clear whether or not they were aware that the president and first lady had been exposed to the coronavirus before they did that?
Oh, it's deeply concerning, Joy. First of all, it looks like the rapid test that the White House is relying on is something called the Abbott ID Now test that's been in commercialization since March. That test has fallen into disfavor in many clinical communities because its false negative rate is as high as 30%. It means you have out of every 10 people who have COVID-19, three actually get a negative test. That's a terrible rate. So they need to scrap that test, number one. And that might be causing some confusion here. Who knows? But number two, of course, the hubris here is just, it's the writing on the wall with respect to hubris and thumbing their nose at science is coming back to haunt them. And the indoor events with no masking, I think it was particularly galling and audacious that our colleagues from the Cleveland Clinic asked them to wear masks and they said no. It evoked what Vice President Pence did in the Mayo Clinic. In a COVID unit, surrounded by doctors and nurses in masks, he was the only one without a mask. This is going to come back to haunt them. It's already doing that now. And I'm hoping that they use this opportunity to turn course here and use this opportunity to now renew a better science-based message for the American people. They have a chance. I hope they take advantage of it.
One can only hope. Dr. Vin Gupta, Jonathan Lemire, Carol Lee, thank you all very much for your time this evening. And up next on The Readout, much more on tonight's big story. Donald Trump taken to Walter Reed Hospital after becoming infected with COVID-19. We'll get reaction from Capitol Hill. And 32 days until Election Day, how Donald Trump's COVID infection affects the race that's already underway. Elections are already happening all over the country. And how should Joe Biden respond to this unprecedented situation? Back with more The Readout after this.
Imagine helping their teeth become four times stronger, preventing cavities up to 40%. Act Kids Fluoride Rinse. Stop imagining. Start acting. And get anti-cavity protection with our dye-free ice formulas. Mornings were made for better.